Now we will understand what is the meaning of cooperative society. A cooperative society is a voluntary association of people who come together to protect and promote their economic interest. The word cooperative means working together and with others for a common purpose. In this form of organization, individuals of the same class join together, pool their resources. Resources means land, capital, or any other. Utilize these resources in the best possible manner with the motive of welfare of the members. It happens that many business organizations have the main motive to earn profits by exploiting customers. But cooperative society provides goods to the society members without profit or at a lower price. In a cooperative society, people can enter it as per their wish, and they are also free to leave a cooperative society, but they cannot transfer their share. In India, the cooperative society is compulsorily required to be registered under the Cooperative Societies Act 1912. The process of setting up a cooperative society is simple. The consent of at least 10 adult members is required to form a society. The capital of a society is raised from its members through the issue of shares. The society acquires a distinct legal identity after its registration. Now we will discuss the characteristics of cooperative society, which are voluntary membership, legal entity, limited liability, democratic management, service motive, distribution of surplus, and number of members. Now we will discuss each of these characteristics one by one. First is voluntary membership. The membership of a cooperative society is voluntary. A person is free to join a cooperative society and can also leave the cooperative society as per his desire. Before leaving the organization, he has to give due notice to the society. Membership is open to all. That is, anyone can join the cooperative society. There is no restriction on becoming the member based on caste, creed, religion, color, and gender. Next feature of cooperative society is legal entity. Registration of a cooperative society is compulsory in India. After registration, a cooperative society acquires a separate identity which is distinct from its members. Distinct means different. The society can enter into contracts. The society can purchase and sell property in its name. The society can sue and be sued by others. As a result of being a separate legal entity after being registered, it is not affected by the entry or exit of its members. Next characteristics of cooperative society is limited liability. The liability of the members of the cooperative society is limited to the extent of the amount contributed by them as capital. Suppose there are 100 members in a cooperative society. Some persons have contributed 500 rupees, Some may have contributed 1,000 rupees, others may have contributed 2,000 rupees. Suppose the total capital of the cooperative society is 1 lakh. So, in case of any dissolution of the cooperative society or any liability being fastened on the cooperative society, the liability of the individual member will be up to the extent of the contribution made by the individual member. That is, if a person has contributed only rupees 500 to the cooperative society towards the capital, his liability will be limited to only rupees 500. If a person has contributed 2000 as capital to the cooperative society, his liability will be limited up to 2000 rupees. This defines the maximum risk that a member can be asked to bear. Next feature of cooperative society is democratic management. In a cooperative society, the power to take decisions lies in the hands of elected management committee. That is, there is a management committee which is elected by the members of the cooperative society, and the members elect the management committee through voting. Each member of the cooperative society has one vote. They choose the members of the management committee. This lends the cooperative society a democratic character. That is, as the members of the management committee are elected by the members of the cooperative society through voting, it is a democratic process. So the cooperative society has a democratic character in, is a democratic character in nature. Service motive. The cooperative society lays emphasis on the values of mutual help and welfare. The main motive of the cooperative society is not to earn profit, as is generally found in case of other business organizations. Its motive is to serve its members. Next feature is distribution of surplus. As the cooperative society performs its functions, some surplus may be generated. If any surplus is generated, that surplus is distributed amongst the members of the cooperative society as dividend in conformity with the bylaws of the society. Now question arises, what is the meaning of bylaws? As a student, we should understand each and every minor point of the course, and we are not to claim any subject. Bylaws means a set of rules made by the society so as to provide the guidelines for its operations and management. It is not that the elected management committee may do anything. It has to perform as per the bylaws as has been framed by the society. So bylaws is the set of rules made by the society so that the operations and the management of the cooperative society is run properly. Now the next point is number of members of the cooperative society. The minimum number of members required to constitute a cooperative society is 10. We may also inform you that we have already uploaded various courses on various topics such as email writing. We have already uploaded courses on present tense, past tense, future tense, then cybersecurity, letter writing, note making, debate writing, DBMS, information technology, and various other topics. You can search for the same on Google. Thanks for watching. If you like our course, please spare some time to give a star rating to our course.